Good morning everyone. My name is Dr. Gujjamma, lecturer in zoology, JMJ College for women. I would like to introduce my Good morning everyone. My name is Dr. Gujjamma, lecturer in zoology, JMJ College for women, Tenali. I would like to give a talk on structure of human heart. Generally, human heart is present at thoracic region. Here we observe it is a thoracic region. Generally, body is divided into three regions. One is called as the cephalic region, that is the head region. Below the head region, thoracic region is present. Below the thoracic region, there is a abdominal region. Heart is present at thoracic region. In this region, at mediastinum, heart is present. The mediastinum is present at between two lungs. Thus, that region is called as the mediastinum. Generally, human heart is having human right hand, right fist size. The human's heart is having the size right fist, and then generally it is having three layers, that is outer ectoderm, generally heart is developed from mesoderm. At embryonic stage, human beings are having three layers that are generally called as the ectoderm, middle mesoderm, and innermost layer is called as the endoderm. In our body, so many structures that are systems and organs are present. These structures and organs are developed from these three layers, that are the ectoderm, mesoderm, and then the endoderm. Generally, the heart is originated from mesodermal layer, that is called as the mesoderm. And it is also having a outermost covering, that is called as the pericardium. Generally, the pericardium is double layered. Between these two layers, there is a space is present. That space is called as the pericardial space. It is filled with a fluid that is called as the pericardial fluid. Functions of pericardial fluid. It keeps heart always moist, reduce friction, and it protects heart from external shocks and mechanical injuries. These are the functions of pericardial fluid. And then the external structure of the human heart. Generally, human heart is having four chambers. The upper chambers are called as the auricles, and then the lower chambers are called as the ventricles. Auricles are generally called as the receiving chambers, and ventricles are generally called as the pumping chambers. Always auricles receive blood from body parts. That means left auricle receives blood from body. That means deoxygenated blood receives right auricle, and left auricle receives oxygenated blood. Heart exhibits four chambers consisting of right and left auricles, right and left ventricles. A distinct transverse groove called auriculoventricular groove or coronary sulcus. It divides the heart is an anterior small and dark red color auricles and a posterior large pale colored ventricles auricles. The two auricles are thin wall chambers completely separated by a thin muscular and ventricle membrane called interauricular septum. In the embryonic development, an opening is present in the septum called as foramen ovale. In the adult, the foramen ovale is closed and represented by a depression called fossa ovalis. Inner surface of auricles is smooth, but a network of lower muscular ridges called musculi pectili is present. Right auricle. It is larger than left auricle. It receives deoxygenated blood from a body parts through three major veins that are called as the pair of precaval veins and an unpaired postcaval veins. The opening of left precaval vein is guarded by the tibiaceous wall. The opening of precaval vein is guarded by a eustachian wall. Right precaval vein has no walls. Right auricle receives a small coronary vein which returns deoxygenated blood from the heart muscles through an opening present close to the left precaval vein. The right auricle opens into a right ventricle through an opening called right auriculoventricular aperture, which is guarded by a tricapsid wall. This wall allows the flow of oxygenated blood from right auricle into the right ventricle. When right ventricle contracts, it prevents backward flow of blood. Left auricle. The left auricle is smaller than right auricle. It receives oxygenated blood from the lungs by a pair of pulmonary veins. These two veins open into left auricle. The left auricle opens into the left ventricle through a left auriculoventricular aperture guarded by a bicapsid wall or mitral wall. This wall allows the flow of oxygenated blood from left auricle into the left ventricle. When left ventricle contracts, it prevents backward flow of blood. And then the next one is the ventricles. The right and left ventricles are separated externally by a ventricle groove called interventricular groove. Coronary arteries are present which send blood to the auricles and ventricles. Right ventricle. The right ventricle is smaller than the left ventricle and its walls are less thicker than the left ventricle. The inner surface of the ventricle's wall projects inwards into an irregular muscular ridges called the columnar cornea, which reduces the internal space of the ventricles. A few coronary line structures are also present, which are called papillary muscles. When the ventricle contracts, these corda tendini prevent the flaps of tricapsid walls to inner into right auricles. These preventing the backward flow of deoxygenated blood right ventricle into the right auricles. From the left side of the right ventricle arises the pulmonary aorta, which opening is guarded by three semilunar walls. Next one is the left ventricle. The left ventricle is little larger than right ventricle and possesses columnar cornea and papillary muscles as the right ventricle. The walls of the left ventricle are more thicker than the right ventricle because it has to pump the oxygenated blood to the part of the body. When left ventricle contracts, these Cartilage tendon may prevent the backward flow of oxygenated blood from left ventricle into the left auricle. From the right side of the left ventricle, a single left system or aorta arises, whose opening is guarded by three semilunar valves. These three are the semilunar valves. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Dr. Bujjamma, lecturer in zoology, JMJ College, Women for Tenali. I would like to give you a talk on structure of human heart. Structure of human heart. Generally, heart is present at thoracic region. Thoracic region between two lungs, that is called as the mediastinum. Generally, it is present at between two lungs. This space is called as the mediastinum. Here we observe it is originated from mesoderm. Mesoderm means human beings at embryonic stage, they are having three layers. It is ectoderm, it is mesoderm, innermost layer is called as the endoderm. From these three layers in our body, systems and organs are developed. Likewise manner, the heart is originated from the middle layer, that is called as the mesoderm. So it is mesoderm in origin. Next one, it is a having outermost layer, that is called as the periosteum. Here heart is covered by a layer. Heart is covered by a layer. Periosteum. Generally, it is the double layer, and it is having space between two layers. Thus, that space is filled with a fluid that is called as the pericardial fluid. Pericardial fluid. What is the use of a pericardial fluid? This fluid protects heart from shocks, injuries. These are the functions of pericardial fluid. Next one, external structure. Generally, human's heart is having four chambers. Four-chambered heart. Four-chambered heart. It is the structure of heart. These are the four chambers. First, second, third, and then the fourth. Upper two chambers are called as the aorticles. Aorticles. And lower large chambers are called as the ventricles. The upper chambers are also called as receiving chambers.
chambers, that are the organs, receives the blood. It receives blood from body parts. It is the deoxygenated blood. And left side organ receives oxygenated blood from lungs. Oxygenated blood, it receives deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood. So these two chambers are generally called as the receiving chambers. And in the below these two chambers, there are larger chambers are present that are called as the ventricles. These auricles and ventricles are separated by a groove that is called as the auriculoventricular groove. Generally, these two auricles and below ventricles, these are separated with the help of a groove that is called as the auriculoventricular septum. It divides the four chambers, and below chambers are called as the ventricles. These chambers are always called as the pumping chambers. Pumping chambers. Why these are called as the pumping chamber? These ventricles are pumps blood. The right ventricle pumping blood to the heart, sorry, lungs. To lungs, and in the left ventricle pumps oxygenated blood to body parts through the systemic arch. Aorta. Here we observe it is the this chamber, right side ventricle is smaller than the left side ventricle. Same manner, right side auricle is smaller than the left side ventricle. Left side auricle. Here, this ventricle, that means left side ventricle, is having thick walls because this chamber pumps blood throughout the body. So, this chamber, that means left ventricle walls are thicker than the right side ventricle. Here it is the pulmonary arch, it is the systemic arch. These two arches are called as the aortic arches. This arch carries deoxygenated blood from right ventricle. It carries blood from right ventricle to the lungs. This is called as the pulmonary arch. Next one, at left side, it is having systemic arch. It pumps blood throughout the body with the help of systemic arch. Always, right side heart is having impure blood, that is the deoxygenated blood, and left side auricle and ventricle is having pure blood, that is the oxygenated blood. Oxygenated blood received from body parts, deoxygenated blood received from the body parts, and in the oxygenated blood pumping to the body parts with the help of systemic arch. It is the structure of heart. Okay, thank you.